In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create this pretty cool loading graphic inside Adobe After Effects. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
Before we dive in, I just want to mention that if you're a patron on my Patreon page, I did make a Mogurt template out of this for Premiere Pro. Feel free to go grab it in the link below, but otherwise, let's see how to create this inside Adobe After Effects. So I'm inside Adobe After Effects, and the first step is to create a new composition. I'm going to go up to Composition, New Composition, and I'm going to name it Loading Bar Animation. And then from the preset, I'm going to choose 4K 29 frames a second, but you can choose whichever resolution that you wish. That's just the one I'm going to choose for this example. I'm going to leave it at 29 frames a second and the duration at 15. Then I'm going to click OK. I'm going to fit my scale to view. So the first thing that we're going to create is the loading bar itself. So the stroke, the outline, and then the fill. So to do that, we're going to go and grab our rectangle tool. So I'm just going to click on it once. And then at the top here, we're going to change our fill and stroke settings. We're going to first focus on the fill. So I'm going to click on the fill and change it to solid color. Then click OK. And then I'm going to go into stroke and then disable it. Then I'm going to click OK. Next, click and draw out your shape. This can be however long and thick that you want your loading bar to be. So in this example, I'm just going to do something like that. Once you have it, I'm going to grab my selection tool, and then I'm going to align the shape to the center of my composition. So to do that, I'm going to go over to my align panel and then just center vertically and horizontally here. If you don't see the align panel, you can always go up to window align, and that will bring up that window. So now that we have this aligned here, what I'm going to do is click on the layer inside my timeline and rename it. I'm going to rename it Loading Bar Fill and then hit Return. Then what I'm going to do is select this layer and hit Command D to duplicate this layer. And then I'm going to change the name of it to Stroke. And then we're going to adjust this layer so it doesn't have a fill, but it does have a stroke. That way the fill and the stroke are separate and we can animate the fill separately from the stroke. So to do that with the layer selected, I'm going to go back into Fill and then disable it. Then click OK and then go over to Stroke and then choose Solid Color and click OK. You can change the color. I'm going to choose this color for now. And then the width as well, I'm going to leave it at 4, but you can adjust it if you want a thicker stroke or outline. So if we click off and we click back on the fill and hide this layer, you'll notice that we have that outline now. Okay, so the next step is to animate the fill. What I recommend doing is pre-composing that layer first and then apply the linear wipe effect. Let's see how to do that. So next, I'm going to click on my layer and right-click and go to pre-compose. Then I'm going to name this Loading Bar Fill Precomp. That way we know it's a pre-composition. And then I'm going to click OK. And you'll see that we have our pre-comp here. I'm going to double click on it to go inside this pre-composition. And what I recommend doing for this effect to work is resize this composition to the exact size of the shape. And to see the exact size of the shape, what I'm going to do is twirl down under Contents, under Rectangle 1, under Rectangle Path. You can see the size in pixels right here. And what I'm going to do is change the comp to these values, also rounding up as well. So what I'm going to do is go to Composition, Composition Settings, and then just change the width to 2371. And this will be different depending on your own layer, so just change it to whatever it says down here for you, because you know not all the shapes will be exact. And then I'm going to change the height to 91, and then click OK. And then what I'm going to do is just select this layer once again, and then just align it vertically and horizontally to the composition. So if we zoom out here a little bit, you can see that this bar is its own element, exactly the width of the composition. So now if we go back into our loading bar animation comp, you can see that we have it here. If you do want to just double check, make sure that you align horizontally and vertically, and this should be aligned here. So next, what we're going to do is select our layer and go to the Effects and Presets window and type in Linear Wipe, and then under Transitions and Wipes, just click and drag this to the composition. And if we play this back, you'll see that we have a nice wipe effect. Now you can adjust the timing, the speed of this, so I'm just going to click on our layer and click U on our keyboard to bring up all keyframes. You can see the default is 1 second, so we can go out to maybe 10 seconds or so, and then just click and drag this keyframe over, while holding down Shift to snap it to the current time indicator. And you can see now we have a 10 second animation for our loading bar here. And you can make this however long you wish, if you want 5 seconds, 15 seconds, but that's how you create that animation inside After Effects. Okay, so now that we have our loading bar, let's create the loading text graphics. So to do that, what I'm gonna do is go up to our text layer, I'm gonna click on the type tool, and then click once to make a new type layer. I'm going to type out what I want it to say, so in this case, loading. And then what I'm going to do is make a few spaces and then add in the percent. So it should look something like this. And if it's not 100% accurate, we can always adjust this later. But the idea here is to have this as its own layer and then the value that changes added as another layer. So what I'm gonna do is click off and then I'm gonna click on this type layer. I'm gonna go to my character panel and you can choose any font. I'm gonna choose this font, Mundial. It is an Adobe font if you do wanna follow along, if you have Adobe Creative Cloud subscription. But what I'm gonna do is go to align and just align this here to the center. And then I'm just gonna click P on my keyboard to bring up position. I'm gonna change the Y position up just a little bit here. That way it rests just above the loading bar graphic here. So now that we have this, what I'm gonna do is click on this layer and hit Command D to duplicate it. And then what I'm gonna do is just rename this 100. That way we have this duplicated layer. And if we hide the other layer, you can see we have 100. And this will be the value that changes over time as it loads from 0% to 100%. So if we unhide the other layer, I'm gonna click on the 100 layer and hit P on my keyboard to bring up position. I'm just gonna scoot this over to the right next to the percent. So it should look something like that. But once you have this set, the next thing that we have to do is animate 100 from 0 to 100. And to do that, we're gonna use expression controls. So first, what you'll wanna do is click on the layer and go up to Effects, Expression Controls, and then we'll add the slider control. And essentially the slider value will change the value from 0 to 100 over time. But first what we have to do is change the source text and make it pick, whip, and follow this value. So what we're gonna do is click on our 100 layer here, and we'll just twirl once and twirl again to bring up the text. Hit twirl one more time and you'll see source text. You'll want to option click on this, or if you're on a PC, on a Windows computer, hold down Alt and click. And then you'll see this pick whip tool. Just pick whip this value to the slider value right here. And once you let go, and once you click off in the timeline, you'll notice that it changes, the value changes to 0. It changes to whatever the slider is, the slider value is. So if we change this to 45, you'll notice that it changes to 45 here. So now what we can do is just keyframe the slider, start at 0, and then if we click in the timeline, click U to bring up our keyframes. We'll go to the last keyframe here of our linear wipe transition, and we'll just change this value to 100. And that way it animates from 0 to 100. But if we play this back, you'll notice that there's decimals. And what we'll have to do is fine tune the expression just a little bit more to round off the values. If we solo this layer, you can see it adds a decimal place with numbers. So to do that, what I'm gonna do is just twirl down back under text, untwirl source text, and then inside here, you'll wanna click in the expression field. So what you'll wanna do is assign this line as a value. So to do that, just go to the beginning of the line, click X or any other letter in the alphabet, then click space equals space. And then go to the end of the line, hit return or enter on your keyboard. And then the expression to round off that variable or that line is gonna be math with a capital M dot round, and then open parentheses, and then type in your variable. In this case, in my example, it's gonna be X. And now if you click off, you'll notice that it rounds it off. So I'm gonna unsolo this layer. And if we click and play this back, you'll see what we have. We have a nice loading bar graphic with a number that counts up here. And this counts all the way up to 100 and it follows the animation. All right, so now that we have our expression and our loading bar graphic, we can stylize this just a little bit more to cap it off. One other thing you'll notice that I did in that template is I added a little flicker effect. Let's see how to do that. So to add a nice little kind of pulsating flicker effect to these values, what I'm gonna do here is click on one of the layers. I'm gonna click T to bring up opacity. I'm gonna click on the stopwatch to keyframe it, go out to about 15 frames, and then knock down the opacity to around 65%. And then I'm gonna go forward to around 1 second and then change this back up to 100. So you can see that it dips down to 65 opaqueness and then it comes back up to 100. And then we can make this loop by adding an expression. So if we option click or alt click on the stopwatch, we can go to our arrow here and then go to property, loop out. And this will loop out the keyframes here essentially. So it'll loop over and over again for the whole duration. You know, you don't have to copy these keyframes over and over again to get that effect. So if we click and play this back, you'll see that loops. So you can see it dims in and out. It basically goes from 100 to 65 in opacity for the whole duration of the composition here. And now that we have that applied, what we can easily do to apply it to the other layers is just click on the value, so the opacity value here or the parameter, hit Command C to copy it, and then just select the other layers by holding down, clicking on one and holding down Shift and selecting the top layer, and hit Command V to paste it. So now when we play this back, you can see that everything is kind of pulsating a little bit. It's going in and out with the opacity. One last thing that you can do is maybe stylize this by adding a glow. So I'm going to zoom in here a little bit here by just pinching on my trackpad. And what we can do is to add a glow to this fill or the blue area, you can right click and just go to Layer Styles, Outer Glow. And then if we twirl down, you can see your options down here. I'm gonna change blending mode to normal, and then I'm just gonna color pick the same color as the bar. And you can play with these values. The big value you wanna change is the size, and this will just increase the size of the glow. And you can knock down the opacity and play around with the settings, but that's essentially how you can add a nice little glow to the bar, just to give it a nice glow effect. So in the end, this is the final result of what we have. So that's how to create the loading bar. Let me know if you have any questions, but I hope you enjoyed today's tutorial. We'll see you guys in the next video.